How much energy does DTF consume? What could that look like in monthly expenses? And how does it stack up compared to other common equipment?
Welcome back to the channel. Today we are performing an energy experiment. And to guide us on this electric journey, we're pulling some members of our shockingly good operations team to assist.
A machine's manual will typically provide max and minimum power consumption.
But what we want to know is how much energy is being consumed over the time period of the print, and what does that equate to financially?
We will measure kilowatt hours on two separate wattage meters alongside time as we print, dry, and press 10 medium-sized graphics. From our data, we will be able to calculate how much energy may cost us per day.
And from days, understand what monthly and yearly bills may look like as well. Okay, let's start our experiment.
We're printing 10 10x10 graphics and starting the clock once printing.
All right, we're printing.
We'll be monitoring our wattage meter throughout.
We'll go back to the kilowatt hours to see we're 0.007.
Well, at least it's registering.
It is.
Keith is telling some engineering jokes to pass the time. That one tickled John. And at the end of printing our 10 graphics, which lasted us 10 minutes, we monitored 0.05 kilowatt hours in total. 10 minutes goes into an hour 6 times, which gives us 0.3 kilowatt hours per hour. If we check our local electricity rates, we can multiply our hourly consumption by Arizona's rate of 13.16 cents for an hourly cost of $3.95. If we're printing 8 hours a day, that's only 31.6 cents a day in electricity costs. Extrapolating the data, this will roughly cost us $9.64 a month and about $116 a year. That's about equivalent to running 3 800-watt refrigerators for 1 hour a day each. Now to measure our dryer consumption, we've summoned Jacob to get everything absolutely perfect before we boot it up. And we're ready to run. Our prints are being powdered, and again, we're monitoring our wattage as they dry. Okay, almost done. Our drying completes at 0.98 in 7 minutes. Let's take a closer look at this information. 7 minutes goes into an hour 8.57 times for 8.4 kilowatt hours per hour. Taking our local electricity costs of 13.16 cents, this is about $1.10 per hour, or for an 8-hour day, $8.80 per day, $268 per month, and $3,221 per year. That's roughly the same as using 2 4,000-watt ovens for 8 hours daily. Next up, pressing. As our press reaches 250 degrees, we see right away our readings go drastically up. The reason being,
the toaster's definitely gonna tick, tick, tick. Toasters, the hair straighteners, my wife's blow dryer.
Oh yeah.
2 kilowatts.
As we press, there are some variables to mention. Our Mamaki printers are Energy Star certified, meaning they have been rated the best in efficiency in their category. Also, we're not measuring downtime, but Mamaki has a sleep mode function that saves a lot of energy while not in use. The humidity and temperature of your room will skew results. It's important to understand your own consumption to impart costs in your overhead pricing and to identify inefficiencies for sustainable practices. The press crosses the finish line at 0.55 kilowatt hours in 4 minutes 30 seconds, going into an hour 13.3 times to give 7.2 kilowatt hours per hour. With our state's electricity rate, pressing costs 96 cents an hour. In a typical 8-hour workday, that's $7.07 and $234.90 monthly. And lastly, $2,818 per year. This is just about the consumption costs of 4 dishwashers used for the same amount of time each day. You can use our findings to estimate your own energy consumption. Just plug in your state's electric costs in cents, multiply it by the hours per day that you're printing, and then by days in a month and month in a year.
Thanks for plugging in. Share your own energy efficient experiences with your printers and subscribe to the channel for more of the latest explorations and tests in DTF.